you know, why don't I have my meetings? I said, well, you can use the boardroom. I said, fantastic. And we're going to charge you. Fantastic, so normally they charge. So I had my meetings in the boardroom. I took a photograph of me in the boardroom with my AC/DC back in black t-shirt, just to make the point that actually they would accept anybody in this particular boardroom. I shared it, got 55,000 views, and like hundreds of comments of people saying, wow, isn't the Ritz-Carlton experience amazing? Isn't the customer experience amazing? One of those people shared it with the CEO of the group who owns the Ritz-Carlton in Singapore, in Hong Kong. And he saw it, a guy called Rico de Blanc, and he came down to see me in the executive lounge of the Ritz-Carlton and said, you need to do our LinkedIn. So now we work for the Ritz-Carlton in Hong Kong, the Ritz-Carlton in Shanghai. And hopefully we're going to build other brands as well. Purely as a result of content marketing. That's authentic content marketing where I was just sharing something, he reacted, he saw me, he could see we did a good job on LinkedIn, and he employed us. And that's just simple. That's how content marketing works on LinkedIn.
That's fantastic. What a success story. I want to save some of the other LinkedIn under the hood type questions for the audience, but before we go to Q&A, a couple more questions. As someone who's a deep practitioner of LinkedIn, how do you see it, you know, maturing from here? And then also, what are your views on the other social media networks, and if they're even worth bothering?
No. None of the others are worth bothering about. And to be fair, I'm not on the other networks. But I say that all the time. I got an RFP today, and they said, we want your opinions and we want your experience about Facebook selling or LinkedIn selling. I said, well, I can't answer the RFP because I know nothing about Facebook. I don't even pretend to know something about Facebook. So you want Facebook and LinkedIn? I can't help you. If you just want LinkedIn, then I'm your man. And they came back to me and said, okay, we'll change the RFP as a result of what you've said, and you can just do the LinkedIn bit. We'll get somebody else to do the Facebook bit. And they suddenly realized that actually there's no point because you can't find an agency, you can do both. We're specialists in LinkedIn. There are many people out there who claim to be specialists in Facebook. I have no idea who they are. So I only use LinkedIn. And even something like WeChat, for example, I only use it to connect via LinkedIn in China. So I use that. I use TripAdvisor because we have a third business called Mohawk Marketing, appropriately enough, which actually does TripAdvisor marketing for entrepreneurs who own hotels, villas, restaurants, bars, and leisure. But the twist is, we put the reviews on LinkedIn. Because they're aiming at a business audience, and many people are, say, CEO retreats or F&B, for example, or sales or work sales, then we manage the TripAdvisor reviews and put the great ones on LinkedIn. Now, no one else is doing that to me. It's bloody obvious. If you get recommendations from people who say, your hotel, your restaurant is fantastic for business, and you don't put it on a platform with 550 million professionals who want to spend money with you, you're missing an opportunity. Those people are not on TripAdvisor. They're looking at LinkedIn. So share the positive reviews there. So that's what my team do there. So we started that in January. It's already taking off. People are going, of course, it's so obvious. And a lot of entrepreneurial ideas are like that. And our four brands are actually all based around LinkedIn. There's just different nuances on LinkedIn. And I see that going from strength to strength. The social selling kicks in more countries, more people are on LinkedIn, more countries take it up. The internet speeds pick up in places like Australia and Indonesia and Myanmar. So that's a joke. If you've ever been to Australia and experienced internet speeds in Australia, you know what I mean. I don't know how to think about it, so it's super fast. To go to Australia, it's like, what is this dialogue you have here?
I wanted to ask you about your other business lines. You just alluded to them. What are they? You said Mohawk. Mohawk marketing is another one.
The other two are the dark arts of marketing. I have to put it in that because we describe black marketing as the dark arts of marketing because you never see us. We take over your profile and we make you a rock star. So actually, we're the underground, we're behind the scenes, we're kind of like the bucket master. And we make things happen. And we never see it. So I call the second brand Dark Arts of Marketing, which is personal branding for entrepreneurs. But beyond LinkedIn. But the problem with doing it beyond LinkedIn, people think, oh, that's fantastic, wonderful. I mean, this is wonderful doing this experience here. But actually, there's like 100 people in this room. Brilliant. But actually, by sharing this with LinkedIn, I reach 100 million people. And that's really the key, is by sharing experiences, by sharing personal branding. I even want to contribute to the Business Times in Singapore. Best world in the world, 10,000 people read my column in the Business Times in Singapore. But when I share it on LinkedIn, 30,000 do, or 40,000 do, or 50,000 do. And you get the kudos of being a Business Times columnist at the same time. So you hit both markets. People who never read the Business Times read my column on LinkedIn. But I get the kudos of being the Business Times, and I hit people who are not on LinkedIn in the Business Times too. And that's what the Australia in Mastery after my books, which is a masterclass plan. So we go around multinational corporations who have got no idea how to use LinkedIn. And most of them have no idea how to use LinkedIn. You can imagine you are struggling how to use LinkedIn. You can imagine a multinational corporation really struggling on LinkedIn. They have no clue about how to use content marketing, how to get blogs approved, employer branding, forcing employees to try and follow a page they don't want to follow, forcing them to share things they don't want to share, because they haven't been empowered and inspired to do so. So we do a masterclass to try and engage your audience and get them willingly to want to share. And often that is not through the company page, it's through the leader. Best example is Richard Branson. Richard Branson has 15 million followers on LinkedIn. People follow him. And by him talking about his experiences, being an entrepreneur, launching spaceships, not quite as successful as Elon Musk, but still launching spaceships. Actually has a zeal that actually abuses all the Virgin companies. So you think all the Virgin companies are sexy, interesting, fascinating to work on. When you go to LinkedIn, you find any of his company pages that have more than 120,000 followers. You can't. No one wants to follow Virgin Atlantic. No one wants to follow Virgin Active or Virgin Money or even Virgin Galactic. They want to follow Richard Branson. So it's all about leaders. It's about you. It's about me. It's about you. It's about you. And that's what it's down to. It's about you marketing your company through LinkedIn. It's about that comes down to personal branding.
So before we turn it over to questions, I'm not going to ask you where we can find you. It's obviously LinkedIn. But is there any, what do you have in the pipeline for 2018? Are you speaking? Or what are you working on this year?
We basically just launched Mohawk. We just launched Australian Mastery. So we're very much building that up, educating the marketplace about TripAdvisor. We just picked up a couple of fantastic hotels in Singapore. We picked up a couple of hotels here in Hong Kong for Mohawk. And then we're black marketing still going from strength to strength. You know, we just employed a lot of people today. We just moved into our third office in our co-working space in Collective Works in Capital Tower in Singapore. If you're ever in Singapore, come and see that one, because that's the best co-working space there. And it's about building that up, it's about training my team, it's about going forward with that. And Dark Hour's only been going for maybe a year, is already going through the roof as well. So all four brands are doing phenomenally well, and that's the challenge in 2018, to just keep that momentum going.
I feel like you could hit every hotel and do the same thing, literally land all these flights. Let's turn it over to Q&A. I mean, the audience, I'm sure you guys are dying.
And you have some questions in the book.